So good morning to one and all. Today we are going to start a very what I can say for second section first chapter, that is nothing but the semiconductor diode. Okay, so in this semiconductor diode you have already learned some of the basic part in the 12th physics. Okay. You have learned what is the semiconductor, what is the PN junction diode, how we are going to make it forward biasing, how we are going to make it reverse biasing. Then also you have studied the characteristics, VI characteristics of the diode. Okay, so these are the basic part related to this chapter. But new things that we have to study in this chapter is nothing but the applications of diode, where that diode can be useful. Okay, so which are that applications? These are nothing but the half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier, and the bridge rectifier. Okay, so these are the applications of the diode. So we have to see what is the use of that full wave rectifier, then half wave rectifier, and the bridge rectifier. Okay, then we have to see what capacitor filter using the full wave rectifier. And then what I can say circuit diagram, we have to see the formula for ripple factor and its working. Okay, that we have to see as the applications of the diode. Then we have to see the special purpose diode. So which are the special purpose diode that we need to see? First, that diode is nothing but the photodiode. Second, the very well-known application, किंवा जो स्पेशल पर्पज डायोड बऱ्याचशा लोकांना माहिती आहे, सगळ्यांनी बघितलेला आहे, दॅट इज नथिंग बट दी एलईडी, विच वी कॅन कॉल इट इज नथिंग बट दी लाईट इमिटिंग डायोड. ओके, अँड वी हॅव टू सी द ऍप्लिकेशन ऑफ दॅट एलईडी ऍज द सेवन सेगमेंट डिस्प्ले. ओके, सेवन सेगमेंट डिस्प्ले सगळ्यांनी बघितलेला आहे, त्याचं आपल्याला कसं वर्किंग आहे, दॅट वी हॅव टू सी. देन यू हॅव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड इन 12th, आय डोंट नो, but my observation is that you have studied Zener diode. Okay, so we can see we will see the working principle of Zener diode, its characteristics, and then last part that we have to see, that is nothing but the Zener diode as the voltage regulator. Okay, Zener diode tumhala jhalay ka 12th physics la, whether you have gone the Zener diode?
Yes.
Okay, so that again we have to revise here, that is what is the Zener diode, what is working principle, then what will be the its VI characteristics, and how we are going to use the Zener diode as the voltage regulator. Okay, now we will start with the basic semiconductor introduction. Okay, so what is the semiconductor? See here, a semiconductor are the substance whose conductivity lies between conductor and insulator. Very simple definition of the semiconductor. Kaya definition? Semiconductor.
Yes,
hello? Semiconductor is one of the substance whose conductivity lies between conductor and insulator. Okay, basically there are three parts as we are going to concern. What is that? Conductor, insulator, and the semiconductor. Okay, apart from this, conductor is having very high conductivity as compared to the remaining two. After that, semiconductor, whose conductivity is in between conductor and insulator. And last comes the insulator, whose conductivity is very less as compared to the conductor and semiconductor. Okay, म्हणजे जर तुम्हाला कंडक्टिव्हिटीच्या ह्याच्यानुसार जर तुम्हाला हे लावायचं झालं, सिक्वेन्स लावायचा झाला, तर पहिलं काय येणार आहे? हु विल कम फर्स्ट? कंडक्टिव्हिटीच्या ह्याच्यानुसार जर सिक्वेन्स लावायचा झाला तर फर्स्ट कोण असणार आहे?
कंडक्टर.
हॅलो,
कंडक्टर्स.
Correct. First are nothing but the conductors. Next, there are semiconductors.
Next
is nothing but the insulators. Okay. And the very famous examples of the semiconductors, these are nothing but the germanium and silicon. These are basically very well known example of the semiconductor. But what you have to keep in your mind, semiconductors are those substances whose conductivity, okay, that's why I have underlined that word, that is nothing but the conductivity. That word is very important. Okay, so semiconductors are the substance whose conductivity lies between conductor and insulator. And well-known example for this conductor and insulators are germanium and silicon. Okay, so this is the very basic definition. As we have started the semiconductor, you should know what is its basic definition, because many of the time the MCQs are going to be asked on this simple point. Okay, we are going to study the very hard point, but simple point we are not going to remind every time. Okay, so see, we will see the next part. That is, what is that next part? See here, they have given, as you are also knowing that, what I can say, see, they have given conductivity is intermediate to metals and insulator. And they have also given its structure, that is valence band, conduction band, where that electrons is present. Okay. But apart from this, see, what is that? See, the semiconductor are basically divided into two parts. So which are that semiconductors? Can anybody knows?
Intrinsic and extrinsic.
Okay. What is that? Intrinsic semiconductor, and next is nothing but the extrinsic semiconductor. Which are that? Intrinsic semiconductors and extrinsic semiconductor. Okay, so as you know that in the semiconductor there is a always presence of covalent bond between the valence electron. Okay, sagalyani kay lakshat thevaychay, in the semiconductor what is present there? There is a presence of what I can say, covalent bond in the valence electron. It dakhavle paha, tenni dakhavle valence electron dakhavlela ahe. Whatever this left hand side structure is there, what this structure is called as? Hela kasla structure manaycha tumhala mahite ka? Ha, whether you found this, this is called as the crystalline structure. Okay, what this called as? The crystalline structure. They have shown here. Okay, and they have shown two important parts here. These are nothing but the free electrons and holes. Okay, so see, they have shown this free electron by the violet color. Okay, and that holes by that particular gray color. Okay, so what it will happen in the pure or intrinsic semiconductors? See, the germanium and silicon is intrinsic semiconductor. Now see what happens. This atom possesses 4 valence electron in the outermost orbit. See here, this germanium atom, tumhi germanium matla kutla pan atom consider kara, teja haja outermost orbit madhe kiti valence electron hai, how many valence electrons are there? 4 valence electrons are there. Okay, so what happens, these 4 valence electrons forms the covalent bond with the another 4 valence electrons of this germanium atom. See here, pratyek tikani tumhala GE stands for the germanium atoms. Okay, now these 4 valence electrons, what they are going to form? They are going to form the covalent bond with the another germanium atom at the normal temperature. Okay, see here, they have given at a normal temperature all the valence electrons of what I can say silicon mana kiwa germanium atoms are in the covalent bond. Okay, te ka ahet covalent bond madhe ahet kadi at a normal temperature. Okay, but if we rise the temperature, rise manje kay apan thodi shi heat tela dili tar kay hote, some of the electrons which are in the covalent bonds breaks the bond and becomes the free. बघा इथे त्यांनी दाखवलंय काय होतंय, वेन एव्हर व्हॉट हॅपन्स ऍट द नॉर्मल टेम्परेचर देर इज अ प्रेझेन्स ऑफ कोवॅलंट बॉन्डिंग बिटवीन दिस जर्मॅनियम ऍटम विथ द आउटर मोस्ट ऑफ 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स बाय द अनदर ऍटम. बट इफ वी आर गोइंग टू इनक्रीज द टेम्परेचर दॅट टाइम व्हॉट हॅपन्स whatever the formation of bond is there in these particular electrons, that bond get breaks and electrons becomes the free. Okay, आता बघा इकडे सगळ्यांनी जस्ट शो सी हियर बघा हा जो पर्टिक्युलर पार्ट आहे तो काय होता हियर मी इथं तुम्हाला राउंड करून दाखवतो इथं काय होतं देअर इज अ पेअर ऑर देअर इज अ कोव्हॅलेंट बॉन्ड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स बट व्हॉट हॅपन्स इफ वी आर गोइंग टू इन्क्रीज दिस टेम्परेचर दॅट टाइम व्हॉट हॅपन्स वन ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ब्रेक्स द कोव्हॅलेंट बॉन्ड from this electrons and it becomes the free baga ita free electrons ita gelela dakhvalay tenni this electrons becomes the free okay and whenever any electrons becomes the free okay so what happen there is a development of holes in that particular semiconductors which are shown by this gray color okay which are shown by this gray color tenni kay sangitle baka see this electron vacancy or deficiency created that is called as the holes okay so due to this breaking of the covalent bond between these two electrons what happen there is a deficiency of electrons is created which is known as the holes of that particular intrinsic or pure semiconductor okay ata he free electrons manjes kay hotayet what will happen free electrons hotayet manjes kay some of the electrons from valence band goes to the conduction band okay some of the electrons from valence band goes to the conduction band see here they have given what I can see right hand side la tenni dakhavlele paha kay zale काही इलेक्ट्रॉन्स जे काय कशात होते व्हॅलन्स बॉन्ड मध्ये होते ते कशात गेलेले आहेत दॅट गोज टू दी कंडक्शन बँड अँड व्हॉट एव्हर दिस गॅप इज देअर ओके बिटवीन दिस टू हे तुम्हाला झालेलं ऑलरेडी सिलिकॉन साठी किती असते त्याला तुम्ही एनर्जी बँड गॅप म्हणताय दॅट इज 1.1 इलेक्ट्रॉन व्होल्ट अँड फॉर जर्मेनियम इट इज 0.74 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स व्होल्ट बट व्हॉट यू हॅव टू कीप इन युअर माइंड इन द इंट्रेन्सिक ऑर प्युअर सेमीकंडक्टर देअर इज अ प्रेझेन्स ऑफ कोव्हॅलेंट बॉन्ड between the what I can say valence electrons and at the normal temperature what happens this free electron whatever this valence electrons are there they are going to make the covalent bond with the another valence electrons of the germanium atom but whenever we are going to increase the temperature that time what happens whenever we are going to increase the temperature some of the valence electrons becomes the free and there is a deficiency of electrons is created which is known as the holes okay which is known as the holes but what you have to keep in mind see in the intrinsic semiconductor the number of electrons is always equal to means what happens jevde electrons free hotil tevdes tithe kay tayar hotil holes tayar hotil barobar hai ka that's they want to say is that jevde tumche electrons free honar tevdes tithe kay create honar there is a creations of the holes there okay everybody got this one हा सगळ्यांना कळेल आहे का एव्हरीबडी गॉट दिस वन ओके नाव सी हियर आपल्याला इथे लक्षात ठेवताना मेन तुम्हाला काय लक्षात ठेवायचं आहे व्हॉट यू हॅव टू कीप इन युअर माइंड हियर द जर्मेनियम ऍटम्स दॅट्स आर बॉन्डेड विथ दिस व्हॅलन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन ओके वेन एव्हर वी आर गोइंग टू इन्क्रीज द टेम्परेचर दॅट पर्टिक्युलर व्हॉट आय कॅन से कोव्हॅलंट बॉन्ड इज गोइंग टू बी ब्रेक अँड देर इज अ फ्री ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स okay and when there is a deficiency of free of electrons is going to be created there is a presence of holes in this particular intrinsic or pure semiconductor okay intrinsic or pure semiconductor manje kay manje he just definition kay the semiconductor which is present in the pure form is called as the intrinsic semiconductor tyamule tela dusra naav kay intrinsic semiconductor plus another name what is the another name for the intrinsic semiconductor you can call it as the pure semiconductor okay you can call it is nothing but the pure semiconductor now next part that is very important that is nothing but the everybody knows that extrinsic semiconductor okay now before this extrinsic semiconductor what we have to study the what is meaning of doping okay and what is the meaning of doping the process of adding a small amount of impurity to an extrinsic semiconductor is called as nothing but the doping of that particular semiconductor. Okay, what is the meaning of doping? The process of adding the impurity into the semiconductor is called as the intrinsic semiconductor. Simple लक्षात ठेवा, बऱ्याचशा लोकांना अजून ज्या वेळेस ते बी ला गेलेले आहे त्यावेळेस सुद्धा डोपिंग म्हणजे काय हे माहित नसते. ओके, व्हॉट इज द डोपिंग? द प्रोसेस ऑफ ऍडिंग द स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ इम्प्युरिटी टू अन इंट्रिनसिक सेमीकंडक्टर इज कॉल्ड एज द डोपिंग ऑफ दॅट पर्टिक्युलर सेमीकंडक्टर. ओके, सो इट्स डेलिबरेट ऍडिशन. डेलिबरेट ऍडिशन मीन्स व्हॉट? आपण पर्पजफुली त्या पर्टिक्युलर सेमीकंडक्टर मध्ये त्याची कंडक्टिव्हिटी इन्क्रीज होण्यासाठी आपण काय करतोय? वी आर गोइंग टू ऍड द इम्प्युरिटी इन टू दॅट पर्टिक्युलर सेमीकंडक्टर. ओके, आपण डेलिबरेटली म्हणजे स्वतःहून आपण त्याच्यात काय करतोय? वी आर पर्पजफुली वी आर गोइंग टू ऍड फॉर इन्क्रीजिंग द कंडक्टिव्हिटी वी आर गोइंग टू ऍड द व्हॉट आय कॅन से इम्प्युरिटीज इन टू द पर्टिक्युलर सेमीकंडक्टर. अँड द इम्प्युरिटी आयटम्स, जो आपण त्यात इम्प्युरिटी आयटम्स आहे, इम्प्युरिटी ज्याची ऍड करणार आहे, त्याला तुम्ही काय म्हणता? यू कॅन कॉल्ड इट इज नथिंग बट द डोपंट्स. What it is called as the, you can call it is nothing but the dopants. Okay, so see, the semiconductor which containing the impurity is called as impure or extrinsic semiconductor. What is that? The semiconductor which containing impurity. म्हणजे आपण एक्सट्रिन्सिक सेमीकंडक्टर मध्ये व्हॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डू? वी आर गोइंग टू ऍड द इम्प्युरिटीज इन टू द पर्टिक्युलर एक्सट्रिन्सिक सेमीकंडक्टर अँड व्हेनेवर सॉरी इंट्रेन्सिक सेमीकंडक्टर अँड व्हेनेवर वी आर गोइंग टू ऍड द इम्प्युरिटी इन दॅट पर्टिक्युलर सेमीकंडक्टर व्हॉट एव्हर दिस सेमीकंडक्टर इज देअर दिस इज कॉल्ड ऍज इम्प्युअर ऑर एक्सट्रिन्सिक सेमीकंडक्टर. एव्हरीबडी गॉट दिस वन? Okay, so see, extrinsic semiconductors, when it will comes into the picture, whenever we are going to add the impurity to that particular intrinsic semiconductor, it becomes the extrinsic semiconductor. Okay, so and whatever the adding, whatever the process of adding the impurity is there, this is called as the doping. And whatever the items which we are going to add, that is called as the dopants. Okay. This is called as the dopants. Now see here, basically as far as this is concerned, how many types of their intrinsic semiconductors are there? Okay, which are that intrinsic semiconductor? The intrinsic semiconductor basically divided into two types, that is nothing but the n-type semiconductor and next is nothing but the p-type semiconductor. Okay, so in the n-type semiconductor, what happens? See here, in the pure or extrinsic intrinsic semiconductor, whenever we are going to add the pentavalent impurities like phosphorus atom consisting of 5 valence electron in its outermost orbit, that particular semiconductor is called as the n-type semiconductor. ओके, एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर मध्ये आपण कुठले इम्प्युरिटी ऍड करतोय? वी आर गोइंग टू ऍड द पेंटावॅलेंट इम्प्युरिटी. व्हाय इट इज कॉल्ड एज द पेंटावॅलेंट इम्प्युरिटी? बिकॉज सी व्हॉट हॅपन्स, दिस पेंटावॅलेंट इम्प्युरिटी कन्सिस्टिंग ऑफ 5 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन इट्स आउटर मोस्ट ऑर्बिट. ओके, how many electrons it is going to consider? It is going to be consider 5 electrons in the outermost orbit. Okay, so which what is the example of that particular pentavalent impurity? Which are the examples? See, phosphorus, arsenic, or what is the SB? SB manje kay kunal maithe ka tumhi study kelela ahe, periodic table in the 12th chemistry. What is that SB? Now this is the homework to you. SB kashacha symbol ahe mahit pahije tumhala? You should know it.
Antimony.
Correct, absolutely. It is nothing but the antimony. Which are the phosphorus, arsenic, or antimony? These are nothing but the pentavalent impurity. Now what I'm going to see here, if here we have considered the example of arsenic, manje itha tumhala example dakhavlela ahe, arsenic cha example dakhavlela ahe ba saganni itha, just see here, here middle one is the arsenic item. Okay, so what happens, it consisting of how many electrons? See here, as this particular arsenic atoms consisting of the what happens, 5 electrons in its outermost orbit. So what it will happen, whatever these 4 electrons are there, that are going to forms the bonds with the germanium atom. Germanium atom cha yacha madhe kiti valence electrons ahet, 4 valence electrons are there. Arsenic, how many valence electrons are there? 5 valence electrons are there. Okay, so what happens is there, that are going to form the bond with the 4 items. Okay, but as we know that how many valence electrons are there, 4 valence electrons, 5 valence electrons are there. So what happens, 1 electron is remaining. Okay, for forming the bonds with this particular another item. Karan tela dusra kutla electrons nahi hai. Kashyasathi? For forming the bond with the another item. That's why in the n-type semiconductor, the electrons are the majority charge carrier. Majority manje kaay? Tenchi majority hai. Kuna peksha? Holes peksha. Okay, jitha kaay? Majority kuna hai? Electrons ahet, kuna peksha jast ahet, hole peksha jast ahet. That's why it is called as the, what I can say, in the n-type semiconductor, what happens, the concentration of the electrons increases than the holes. That's why in this n-type semiconductor, electrons are the majority charge carrier and holes are the minority charge carrier. Or you can, in another word, you can say that the electrons are responsible for the flow of the currents. Okay, but aplyala MCQ yetana kase yenar aahe, in the particular exam MCQs are going to be asked on this particular point, is that which are the majority charge carrier, which are the minority charge carrier in n-type semiconductor, which impurity we are going to use, which impurity we are going to use, pentavalent impurity, which consisting of the 5 electrons in its outermost orbit. Okay, now see here, what these are the very very important points as far as these MCQs are concerned. Okay, MCQ itha baga kiti MCQ tayar hote, n type madhe apan kutle impurities add karto, pentavalent pahile MCQ, tyachyanantar kutle kutle example ahet pentavalent impurity che, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony. Okay, this is the second MCQ. Next, what is the third MCQ? It is possible which are the majority charge carrier and which are the minority charge carrier. Electrons are the majority charge carrier and holes are the minority charge carrier. And in the n-type semiconductor, whose concentration is more than whom? Electrons concentration is more than the holes in the, what I can say, n-type semiconductor. Okay, sagyanna kalle ka MCQ kashe yetet, how the MCQs are going to be asked in this particular point. Okay, now next is nothing but the, which is very important, p-type semiconductor. Okay, p-type semiconductor madhe kay asnar aahe, which impurity we are going to add into this p-type semiconductor? Trivalent impurities we are going to add into this particular p-type semiconductor. Okay, trivalent impurity ani n madhe pentavalent impurity, barishi mula jo parent final exam yete तो पर्यंत सुद्धा कन्फ्युजन मध्ये असतात की पेंटावॅलेंट कुठे आहे आणि ट्रायव्हॅलेंट कुठे आहे. तर काहीतरी एखादा शॉर्टकट लक्षात ठेवा, लक्षात ठेवायचा, कारण कसं आहे याच्यावर भरपूर भरपूर म्हणजे भरपूर वेळेस एमसीक्यू आलेले आहेत, त्यामुळे आपल्याला ते माहितीच पाहिजे. ओके, पेंटावॅलेंट इम्प्युरिटी म्हणजे काय, ट्रायव्हॅलेंट इम्प्युरिटी आणि कुठे ऍड करतो आपण. आता इनटू द, एज फार एज दिस ट्रायव्हॅलेंट इम्प्युरिटी इज कंसर्न, द व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट ऑर व्हाट आय कॅन से व्हेरी फेमस एक्झाम्पल ऑफ दिस ट्रायव्हॅलेंट इम्प्युरिटी इज इंडियम. Okay, so what, as far as this trivalent impurity is concerned, so what it will happen, it consisting of the 3 electrons in its outermost orbit. Okay, what happens, 3 electrons in this outermost orbit. So what happens, the four electrons of a germanium atom is having the four valence electron in its outermost orbit. So what happens? Three electrons of this indiums are going to form the covalent bond with the three germanium atoms. काय होणार आहे इंडियमचे जे तीन व्हॅलन्स इलेक्ट्रॉन आहे ते पर्टिक्युलर जर्मेनियम ऍटम बरोबर काय करणार आहेत बॉन्ड फॉर्म करणार आहेत पण आता काय होणार आहे एक जर्मेनियमचा ऍटम असा असणार आहे की त्याच्यासोबत कोण नसणार आहे देर इज अ नो प्रेझन्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फॉर दिस पर्टिक्युलर कोव्हॅलंट बॉन्ड सो ड्यू टू दॅट व्हॉट हॅपन्स देर इज अ एक्झिस्टिंग ऑफ व्हॅकन्सी ऑर व्हॅलन्सी इज देअर अँड विच विल क्रिएट दी होल्स okay which will creates the holes okay that's why in the p type semiconductor holes are the majority charge carrier and electrons are the minority charge carrier everybody got this one lakshat the aplyala lakshat yachi mechanism lakshatas thevta ali paije what is that into the p type semiconductor only three electrons of this particular impurities are going to form the covalent bond with the what I can say germanium or silicon atoms but what one of the electrons which is not having any electrons for what I can say bonding with this particular germanium atom so due to that there is a creation of the vacancy or what I can say electrons vacancy is there which is called as nothing but the holes so it is what I can say in the p type semiconductors holes are the majority charge carrier holes are the majority charge carrier okay so see here they have given which are the example like that gallium indium aluminium but most of the we are using the gallium and indium as the what I can say trivalent impurity for this n type semiconductor okay we are using the trivalent impurities for this n type semiconductor okay so what you have to keep in mind into the p type semiconductor we are going to add the trivalent impurity in this particular p type semiconductor the famous example are indium or gallium here in this particular p type semiconductor there is a creation of hole due to the absence of electrons so here the holes are the majority charge carrier and electrons are the minority charge carrier okay so these are the related to the basic types of the semiconductor that is nothing but the first is the intrinsic semiconductors and next is nothing but the extrinsics in the intrinsic semiconductor when we are going to add the impurity that is doping it becomes the extrinsics which again divided into two types these are nothing but the n type semiconductor and the p type semiconductor okay now another very important point that everybody is going to focus and which is very important for us that is nothing but the p type semiconductor and the n type semiconductor okay so what it will happens see here whenever the p type semiconductor just a minute okay so what is this pn junction diode see when a p type semiconductor is joined to the n type semiconductor such that see there is a crystal structure remains to continuous at this boundary which resulting arrangement is called as pn junction diode okay baga manje jawes whenever we are going to form or whenever we are going to join the p type semiconductor with the n type semiconductor and here is the presence of boundary which is shown by this dotted line ashi ja veles arrangement asel tya veles tya arrangement la tumhi kay mhanar aahe you can call it is nothing but the pn junction diode or आता आपण पुढे काय बघणार आहोत, सिंपली त्याला आपण काय म्हणायचं, डायोड म्हणायचं फक्त, जे की आपण पुढचा पार्ट बघणार आहोत काय, दॅट इज नथिंग बट दी ऍप्लिकेशन्स ऑफ डायोड. प्रत्येक ठिकाणी आपण असं म्हणत बसणार नाही की पीएन जंक्शन डायोड, पीएन जंक्शन डायोड, पीएन जंक्शन डायोड. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू से लाईक दिस. ओके, व्हॉट वी आर गोइंग टू से लाईक दिस, पीएन जंक्शन डायोड. पीएन जंक्शन डायोड, व्हॉट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ दिस पीएन जंक्शन डायोड? व्हेनेव्हर अ पी टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर इज गोइंग टू बी जॉइंड विथ द एन टाइप सेमीकंडक्टर, ओके, सच दॅट देअर इज अ क्रिस्टलाइन बाउंड्री अरेंजमेंट इज फॉर्म, दॅट अरेंजमेंट इज कॉल्ड ऍज द पीएन जंक्शन डायोड. पण तुम्ही लक्षात ठेवतानाच काय लक्षात ठेवायचं फक्त, ओके, व्हॉट यू कॅन कीप इन युअर माइंड, व्हेनेव्हर वी आर गोइंग टू जॉईन दी पी टाईप सेमीकंडक्टर विथ दी एन टाईप सेमीकंडक्टर अँड व्हॉट एव्हर दी अरेंजमेंट इज गोइंग टू बी फॉर्म, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज दी पी एन जंक्शन डायोड. ओके, अँड व्हॉट एव्हर दिस होल अरेंजमेंट इज देअर, दॅट इज इलेक्ट्रिकली न्यूट्रल. व्हॉट इज मीन्स इलेक्ट्रिकली न्यूट्रल? देर इज अ नो स्पेसिफिक चार्ज ऑन दिस पर्टिक्युलर पी एन जंक्शन डायोड, दॅट्स वाय इट इज कॉल्ड एज दी इलेक्ट्रिकली न्यूट्रल. ओके, now see what we have to important for us, important for us is nothing but the how we are going to, okay, sorry, now there is a very important point comes into the picture, is that there is a formation of the depletion layer or depletion region. So what is the depletion region? See, what happens whenever we are going to form the PN junction diode near to that boundary, what happens? See here, जी काय आपली बाउंड्री होती, nearest to boundary, हे जे काय बाउंड्री होती त्या बाउंड्री मध्ये काय होते, See here, जी here the positive or negatives which are shown here, je kai ikda charge carrier ahet kashat, into the p type and into the n type, te ka hota hai, they are going to combine for this some region, ta thoda sha region madhe ka hota hai, they are going to combine, okay, tithe region dakhavle pa, depletion region, depletion region म्हणजे काय करतायत, इकडचे एन मध्ये जे पॉझिटिव्ह होतं ते काय करतायत, पी च्या निगेटिव्ह कडे जायला बघतायत, अँड व्हॉट एव्हर दी निगेटिव्ह फॉर पी इज देअर, दे आर गोइंग टू ट्राय टू मूव टुवर्ड्स दी पॉझिटिव्ह ऑफ दिस एन. आणि त्याच्यानंतर तिथे एक रिजन फॉर्म होतोय, कशाचा, असा पर्टिक्युलर रिजन फॉर्म होतोय, त्याच्यानंतर काय असणार आहे, इकडचे इकडे पण पी चे एन कडे पण नाही जाऊ शकणार आणि एन चे पी कडे पण नाही जाऊ शकणार. तो जो काय रिजन आहे, दॅट पर्टिक्युलर रिजन इज कॉल्ड एज नथिंग बट दी डिप्लिशन रिजन ऑफ दॅट पर्टिक्युलर पी एन जंक्शन डायोड. म्हणजे अशी एक वेळ येणार आहे की त्यावेळेस काय होणार आहे, नो वन फ्रॉम एन गोज टू दी पी साइड अँड नो वन फ्रॉम पी गोज टू दी एन साइड अँड व्हॉट एव्हर दॅट रिजन इज देअर दॅट फॉर्म, दॅट रिजन इज कॉल्ड ऍज दी डिप्लिशन रिजन, जो की तुम्हाला तिथे दाखवलाय पहा, डिप्लिशन रिजन. ओके, फक्त लक्षात राहू द्या, डिप्लिशन रिजन फॉर्म होणार आहे, दॅट इज नियर टू दॅट पर्टिक्युलर पी एन जंक्शन डायोड. ओके, there is no possibility from go here to here and here to here and that particular region is called as nothing but the pn junction diode. Now apart from this pn junction diode, what is there, there is another important consideration which will be involved in this pn junction diode, is nothing but the forwarding biasing of this pn junction diode and reverse biasing of this pn junction diode. So what is forward biasing of the PN junction diode? Kon sangte ka forward biasing? What is the forward biasing? Whenever the P type from this PN junction diode is going to connected with the positive terminal of the battery and N is connected to the negative terminal of the battery and whatever the arrangement is going to be formed, that arrangement is called as the forward biasing of the PN junction diode. Okay, what we are going to call this forward biasing of this PN junction diode? Whenever the P type of that PN junction diode is going to be connected with the positive terminal of that particular battery. See here, ata tumhala dakhavto baka saganni ite laksha dya, this is the P which is connected to this positive and this N which is connected to negative, and whatever this arrangement, whole arrangement is there, this arrangement is called as PN junction diode is connected in the forward biased condition. Okay, सगळ्यांनी लक्षात घ्या, फॉरवर्ड बायसिंग कंडिशन म्हणजे आपल्याला माहित पाहिजे, कारण ज्या वेळेस आपण आता ह्याचे ऍप्लिकेशन बघणार आहोत, कशाचे, पीएन जंक्शन डायोड आणि सेमीकंडक्टरचे ऍप्लिकेशन बघणार आहोत, हाफ वेव्ह रेक्टिफायर, फुल वेव्ह रेक्टिफायर, त्यावेळेस आपल्याला माहित पाहिजे की कुठला डायोड फॉरवर्ड बायस मध्ये आहे, कुठला डायोड रिव्हर्स बायस मध्ये. कसं ओळखणार आपण? व्हेनेव्हर दॅट पर्टिक्युलर पी टाइप इज कनेक्टेड टू दी पॉझिटिव्ह अँड एन टाइप इज कनेक्टेड टू दी निगेटिव्ह अँड व्हॉट एव्हर दी arrangement is there, that is called as the, what I can say, what that arrangement we can call they are connected into the, what I can say, forward bias conditions. Okay, they are connected in the forward bias condition. And the very opposite arrangement, what is that? Reverse bias. Okay, so what happens in the reverse bias condition? See. What is that? See, these particular, what I can say, P-type is connected to this negative and N-type is connected to this positive. And whatever the arrangement is the form, that we can call, it is nothing but this. What I can say, this arrangement is called as this reverse biasing of the PN junction diode. This arrangement is called as the reverse biasing of this PN junction diode. Whenever your P-type is connected to the negative terminal and N is connected to the positive terminal, and whatever that arrangement is there, that is called as this particular, what I can say, this is called as this P reversing biasing of your PN junction diode. Reverse biasing of your PN junction diode. What is important for us? See, important for us, आपल्यासाठी important काय? Forward biasing म्हणजे काय आणि reverse biasing म्हणजे काय? Forward biasing, whenever we are going to connect P type with the positive and N type with the negative, whatever the arrangement is formed, that is called as the forward biasing. Okay, and whatever this reverse biasing, whenever we are going to connect P type with this particular negative and whenever we are going to connect N with this positive, and whatever this arrangement is formed, this is called as the, what I can say, reverse biasing of this PN junction diode. This is called as the reverse biasing of this PN junction diode. Everybody got this one? Positive biasing, sorry, forward biasing and reverse biasing of this PN junction diode. Everybody got this one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So,